Hey y'all, welcome back to my channel. You already know what to do. Go ahead and hit that subscribe button and don't forget to hit that like button at the end of this video. So let's go ahead and get started. You already know I'm applying my base, a little bit of base, buff that out. I'm gonna apply a very small, tiny, you know, I usually take like the cap of my setting powder, and I use this to set my eyes because I don't want too much powder on there. So I'm gonna take a little dab of that and I'm gonna swipe that on my eyes. So this is going to be really hard to explain, y'all, so y'all got to listen up. So I'm going to take my James Charles palette with this blue color. This is a fluffy blending brush, and I'm going to apply this basically in the motion of how I want my cut crease to go. So I'm going to apply this to the top of my lid, and I'm going to fluff it out towards the end of my eyebrow, if you get what I'm saying. Now, I honestly feel like I put this eyeshadow a little bit too far up, because after we finish with this blue eyeshadow, I'm gonna go in with the green eyeshadow. So you'll be able to see like how much lower I put the eyeshadow on this eye than the other eye, because I realized, and you guys, this look was kind of like freestyled. It didn't come out the way that I was thinking it was gonna come out, but it still came out cute. I just kind of went along the way. But anyway, yeah, try not to put that first color blue up a little too far, because then it'll be a little bit harder to apply that green. But anyway, I'm going to go in with another blending brush, but this time this blending brush is a little less fluffy. I don't know what to call it. It has a little bit more precision, and I'm going to blend out the edges of that blue eyeshadow with this green, and it's going to create this really, really cute color. I don't even know what to call it, but it's just, I'm going to just call it sexy. It's just a sexy color. Okay, so now that we blended that out to perfection, I'm going to take this deep kind of navy blue color, and this is going to create some depth for our eyes, you know, some depth. This is going to bring life into our eyes. This is going to bring a personality to our eyes. It's just going to bring pizzazz to our eyes. Okay, so I'm going to take an even smaller blending precision brush, and I'm going to basically follow my brow bone line. Follow your brow bone line, you guys. You do not have to be so extra and act like you don't know where your brow bone is. Feel for your eyebrow bone and put the navy blue right there. So now I'm going to go in and I'm going to cut my crease. I'm sorry, you guys. I cannot explain how to cut a crease. I just know how to cut a crease. If you guys need a video on how I cut my crease, then just let me know, because I have like a very precise way, or a very specific way I do my cut crease for some reason. But anyway, I'm going to go into my NYX palette next, and I'm going to apply this light sky blue. Now, I know I'm going into different palettes, you guys, sometimes, but it's a little bit hard for me to stay in one palette when I'm trying to do different colors with a look, because not every palette has every color that I need. Now, for these shadows, this was literally freestyle, you guys. Like, for my cut crease, the colors was literally freestyle. I had no idea. I was going for no yellow, for... I didn't know what I was doing. So you can tell, like, all in my face, I was looking, trying to see, or trying to plan out, or trying to make sure that the eyeshadows look good, right? And it actually came out good in the end, so I'm kind of proud of myself, okay? Period. But anyway, yeah, this was not planned. So I took a light blue, put that further to the back. I put the yellow in my corners, and then I'm going to go in with the green. And I'm just trying to figure out colors that kind of go together and don't really clash. Like, I don't want colors that's like completely opposite. Like, you know what I mean? Like, not for what I'm trying to do here. Not for what I'm trying to do here. But anyway, you guys get my point. Okay, so for some reason at the end of this video, I decided to put orange somewhere in there. So this is the finished look. I just put the orange in between the yellow and the green. I look like I was going for a sexy butterfly, but I feel like it came out more like a sexy peacock. But that's okay, because it's like a mixture of both. But anyway, I'm going to go in with some highlighter for my face, just for underglow. This is from Becca Cosmetics, I think. I might be wrong, you guys, so I have to put this down in the description box below. But I'm gonna go ahead and do my normal face routine. You already know I'm using my Wet n Wild foundation in the color Cocoa. Then I'm going to go in with my concealers. My concealer that I use from NARS, and then also my concealers that I use from LA Girl Pro Concealer, the medium beige, and then I also mix that with a tiny bit of pure beige just for an extra highlight. And here's a quick tip, you guys, before I shut up for the rest of the face routine, because this is pretty much self-explanatory. Y'all forgot what I was about to say. Oh my god. What was I about to say? Oh, I remember, y'all. I remember. If you leave your foundation on for a little bit longer, it'll thicken up the foundation so that... So you're using less product. If you're using a foundation that's a little bit thin, you can leave it on for a few minutes and that will thicken the makeup up. And that's with concealer or foundation, you guys. With Wet n Wild, I don't need to do that. Wet n Wild is the bomb, but I'm just saying. I'm so mad I forgot.
Gonna finish my under eye. So I'm gonna take two different colors. I'm gonna take that green that we used earlier that went over top of our blue in the beginning of the video, but I'm also gonna mix that with some yellow. And what this is gonna do is create like a more vibrant kind of green. So it's almost gonna look like neon green kind of once I get finished. You guys will see. And it looks really cute. Like the difference between just putting green and just putting yellow, it looks a lot more bright, right? Yeah, it's really cute. So now I'm gonna go in with that NYX eyeshadow base, that white eyeshadow base, and I'm gonna apply this to my lower lash line, and this is just gonna brighten and help my eyes to pop a little bit more. So after I get finished that, I'm gonna carefully put on a light coat of mascara on my bottom lashes, just you know, so that my lashes are not bald. Now for our last steps, I'm going to apply some clear lip gloss. I'm not going to rub my lip gloss in because I don't like rubbing my lip gloss in because I feel like it messes up my lipstick. So after that, I'm going to apply a little bit of my Juvia's highlighter. But I'm going to apply a small amount of this because I want the focus to be more on my eyes. And I don't want my highlight to overpower my eyeshadow. So I'm only going to put a little bit just for a nice, you know, wet glow.
Now I'm going to go into my BH Cosmetics foil palette and I'm going to take this light yellow, like lemonade kind of color, and I'm going to spray this with a little bit of setting spray, and this is going to help the foil shadow to kind of brighten up a little bit more. And I'm going to apply this in the inner corner of my tear duct. And because I'm applying this in between a yellow and like a really like neon green, it's giving a combination of both. It kind of gives that illusion. And this is the finished look, you guys. Thank you so much for tuning in. Please do not forget, as always, I always tell y'all this, don't forget to hit that like button. Do not forget to hit that subscribe button. And please do not forget to leave your thoughts and comments down in the comment section below, because you already know that I definitely want to hear from my besties. I love you guys so much, and I'll see you in the next video. Bye.